This is a demonstration of the Crux WVI Wi-Fi video interface for Android systems. The Crux WVI functions as essentially a Wi-Fi interface between your device and the radio, and it has a Wi-Fi transmitter built into it that'll make the connection, allow you to stream the output of your device to the Crux piece, and via its red, white, and yellow RCAs, it will output that to your stereo. In this case, we booted it up in the Miracast mode as opposed to the AirPlay mode. This is the Miracast is the Android, the AirPlay is Apple. And what we'll do to get this booted up here is we're going to use a Samsung Note 4 Edge, brand new phone. We simply hit the settings button. We go down to more networks, come down to screen mirroring, and simply tap the hotspot. We see the same address on the phone as is called out on the face of the unit, so you know you're connected to the right piece. You hit hotspot and you see it'll start its Wi-Fi direct connect. Once it gets that connection made and the two units start talking to each other, it'll simply start mirroring the output of the phone directly to the Crux piece. There we go. Wi-Fi direct succeeded. Now everything that you see on the phone is displayed on the radio. So we can then start navigate and do anything we want to on the phone. It will show up exactly the same way on the radio or on your overhead screen. Whatever display unit you've got, the unit connected to will output the mirror of the display. Now keep in mind, this is a one-way communication. You still have to navigate the phone on the phone. You cannot do any navigation or any control from the radio. It's only from the phone to the radio. One of the apps we've been asked the most about is Netflix. And very obviously, it's a huge advantage to be able to use Netflix on your screen in the vehicle. And this is a demo of exactly how it works. Simply bring up your Netflix app, choose the movie you want to watch, and hit play. And very obviously, there you go. You've got Netflix output. Any movie that's available on Netflix, you have the ability to stream in the vehicle, along with all the navigation that you've been used to using. Simply use it on the app on the phone. You get that output right onto the radio or whatever screen you're displaying it on in the vehicle. Along with audio, video, everything you'd expect is all there. As long as we've got a decent Wi-Fi connection or cellular data connection, you'll see exactly the same thing that is on the phone on the radio, and of course we get output audio through the radio, and it is a perfectly acceptable display, and nothing at all wrong with that. It's just what you'd expect if you were watching that on any display that you'd care to. One of the better apps that we can use on the phone is Sling Player. And Sling Player allows us to tap into the Sling Box we've got at home. In this case, we've got the Sling Box set up. And through the Sling Player app, we can then output our home TV system directly through our phone. And there we go. We have live TV streaming from our home cable box directly to our to our phone, and by extension out to our Wi-Fi piece or our WVI piece. So now we can still get live TV. We can change channels. We can do anything we want on our home TV, just exactly as if we were sitting in front of it, and have full control, full output, everything that we want in our car. As long as we've got a cellular connection, we now have that capability to output that onto our radio. We can output our maps the same way. So everything that we do on our Google Maps is mirrored on our display. We can use this as our navigation system, just the same way that we would use it on the phone, except we can see that display on the radio. We can also, for instance, if we choose to, while we're doing our maps, we want to get Pandora up and running, we can start our Pandora. There's output. And still go back to our Google Maps and have it navigate our way wherever we want to go while you're listening to Pandora. No problem. So it really does double duty as a navigation system as well as audio. Any app that we want to utilize on the display of the radio can be output as long as it is capable of being output from the phone. For instance, Google Earth. If we want to do that output, we simply bring up Google Earth. There we go. Anything that we do on the phone will then output to the radio display. So very obviously we have full capability, and the output of any app, anything that can be displayed on the phone, can be displayed on the radio. Video that's contained on the phone or on the device is also accessible. Simply choose your video app on the phone, and the video that's contained on the phone, in this case, let's say we want to get to Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, we simply start that playback, and you can see on the phone we've got no output. It's simply output on the radio itself. We still have full control of the playback directly from the phone, so we can play, pause, we can do anything we want to navigation wise on the phone, but the output is sent out to the WVI, and it's very acceptable. Everything that you'd expect from that video output is just simply sent out to the radio itself. Very, very nice display, and opens up many avenues for audio and video playback. So that's the demo of the Crux WVI Wi-Fi video interface on an Android system.